Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video series, we started discussing Commvault schedule policies. In our previous videos, we discussed how to create a new file system backup schedule, and also discussed their advanced backup options. In this video, we will exclusively discuss schedule pattern tab. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. Schedule name displays the name of the schedule. Here you see the available schedule patterns. One time runs a job a single time. Select the date and time you want the job to begin. Click Options to display Advanced Schedule Options window. Time Zone allows you to schedule a job by selecting a time zone. You can run the job in either CommServe time zone or Client time zone if required. Select a time zone from the drop-down list. Daily runs a job on a daily basis. Choose the start time of the backup. Repeat repeats the job based on the options you select. Every n days is how often to repeat the job. Set the interval in days at which you want the job to repeat. For example, you can repeat the job every 4 days. Exceptions defines days of the month to exclude from the schedule. Exceptions window. Use this window to create, modify, or delete an exception to a weekly schedule. Add allows you to choose a particular weekday or day of the month for which to exclude the schedule. New exception window. Days allows you to choose a particular day or days of the week for which to exclude the schedule. On option helps you to select the first, second, third, fourth, or last weekday of the month to exclude this schedule. The schedule operation will not run on the day selected. Use Edit to modify the existing exceptions to the schedules, and Delete to delete existing exceptions to the schedules. Repeat every n hours, n minutes, until. On an hourly basis, select how often to repeat the job and when to stop repeating the job. Click Options to display the Advanced Schedule Options window. Range of recurrence. Enter the start date on which you want this schedule to take effect. Choose one of the following to set an end boundary for the schedule. Never end is to keep this schedule valid indefinitely, which is the default. End by is to set the last date on which this schedule will be effective. After this date, the schedule is deleted within 24 hours. End after is to maintain the schedule until a specified number of jobs run. After the specified number of jobs run, the schedule is deleted within 24 hours. If all of the schedules on a schedule policy are automatically deleted, the schedule policy is also deleted. Time zone allows you to schedule a job by selecting a time zone. Select a time zone from the drop-down list. Weekly runs a job on a weekly basis. You can run the job every n number of weeks on the selected days of the week. Set the start time of the schedule. Select the days on which you wish to run the schedule. For example, if you want to run full backup once a week on a Friday, then you select Friday here. If you want full backup to run twice a week, say on a Monday and Friday, then you select Monday and Friday here. Repeat repeats the job weekly based on the options you select. We have already discussed these options. We have discussed exceptions as well, which defines days of the month to exclude from the schedule. Click Options to display the Advanced Schedule Options window. We have already discussed these options. Monthly runs a job on a monthly basis. Select the start time of the schedule. Select a date of the month on which the schedule should run. Choose the schedule to run on specific day on the month, like the first Sunday of the month. Repeat repeats the job based on the options you select. Select how often to repeat the job in every month. On an hourly basis, select how often to repeat the job and when to stop repeating the job. We have already covered exceptions and advanced schedule options window. Yearly runs a job on a yearly basis. Set the start time for the schedule. You can run the job annually on the selected date of a month. You can also set the schedule to run on a particular day of a month, like the first Sunday of January month. Repeat every n hours, n minutes, until repeats the job on an hourly basis. Select how often to repeat the job and when to stop repeating the job. Options takes you to the Advanced Schedule Options window, which we have already covered. Automatic Schedule automatically runs a backup job when specific criteria are met. Automatic schedules can be set for laptop client data backups, database log backups, and synthetic full backups. Job interval, set up the job based on the log files in the destination directory. Backup on file activity, every n hours and n minutes. This parameter ensures that the software does not frequently run the job. The software does not check the other options during this interval. Force a backup every n hours and n minutes. This parameter ensures that the software backs up the logs even when the other options have not been met. For example, if the parameter is set to 24 hours and the software has not run an automatic log backup in that time, the software will start a backup without checking the other options. Laptop tab. This tab appears when a schedule is part of a schedule policy. Job interval. Minimum sync interval. Time interval in hours after which files will be synced. If a change is detected between the latest backed up files and the local files on the laptop, then a backup will take place. Ignore the blackout window when a backup is forced. Ignores the blackout window rules for the time period specified in the maximum interval between jobs option and continues the backups on the laptop client. Network management allows you to specify the available network types. Select Use only wired network to start the job when the network connectivity is wired. Select Minimum network's bandwidth in kbps to specify the minimum number of kbps that the job should use for the network bandwidth. By default, the minimum bandwidth is 128. Select Use only specific network to start a job using a specific network. Enter a full IP address or an IP address pattern for the subnet mask. Select Do not use a network configured as metered to disable laptop backups when a wireless network is marked as metered. Select Manually choose the preferred network to configure specific networks for laptop backup jobs. Laptop users configure the networks by using the Edge Monitor Add Networks option. Power management allows you to specify power management options for the computer. Start only if the computer is running on AC power, runs the job only when the computer is on AC power. Stop the task if battery mode begins, stops the job if the computer is on battery mode. Prevent computer from going to sleep if any jobs are running, ensures that the computer does not enter sleep mode when console jobs are running. Resource utilization allows you to set up the job schedule with specific resource utilization. Start only if CPU utilization is below N%, runs the job when CPU utilization is below the specified percentage. Suspend jobs if CPU utilization is above N%, suspends the job when CPU utilization is above the specified percentage. As the note says, the above options will work when this schedule will run only on client installed as laptop. Databases tab. This tab appears when a schedule is part of a schedule policy, and these options apply to databases. Database log management. Use disk cache for log backups, and commit every N hours, enables the log caching feature, and runs the log caching job at the specified interval. Start backup when disk at log destination is N% utilized, runs the job when the log files on the disk use this percentage of the storage space. The default is 80%. Number of archived logs in log destination, runs the job when the number of log files on the disk reach this number. The default is 100. Start the backup when the log file is N% utilized, runs the job when the percentage of space used in the log file exceeds this number. Synthetic full tab is grayed out, as that option is not selected in the schedule. If selected, you see the tab enabled. Run synthetic full every X days defines the number of days that should pass between synthetic full backup jobs. As needed for extended retention defines the number of days that should pass between synthetic full backup jobs, based on the storage policy's extended retention rules defined by the user. If extended retention rules are not configured, then synthetic full backup jobs will run every 30 days. As needed to reclaim space triggers a synthetic full job when the current size of application on the client is less than the total size of the backed up data in the current job cycle by a threshold value. Default value is 50%. The synthetic full backup jobs will run every 30 days from the past full or synthetic full job, regardless of whether data savings is less than threshold. Continuous runs an administration or backup job continuously. The next job session of a continuous schedule starts automatically after the previous job completes. You can define the time interval between two backup job sessions. By default, the next job session starts 30 minutes after the previous job session completes. We will end this video here. In our next video, we will continue discussing the other schedule features or options. Please hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.